In this video, I'll get into data types, specifically scalar types. A scalar type represents a single value and includes integers, floating point numbers, booleans, and characters. If you're familiar with other programming languages, you'll recognize these data types. Let's explore how they work in Rust. First up, let's dig into integers. Integers are whole numbers, and they can either be signed or unsigned. Signed indicates that a number has a plus or a minus sign, so it can either be positive or negative. Unsigned numbers have no sign and are always positive. This table shows the following integer types that exist in Rust. There are various lengths for each signed and unsigned variable. Each signed variant can store numbers from 2 to the n minus 1 to 2 to the n minus 1 minus 1. So if I have an i8, so a signed 8-bit integer, then that can go from a range of 128 to 127. Unsigned variants can store numbers from 0 to 2 to the n minus 1. So an unsigned 8-bit integer can store numbers from 0 to 255. Additionally, the isize and usize type depends on the kind of computer your program is running on. 64 bits if you're running on 64-bit architecture, and 32 bits if you're using 32-bit architecture. The primary situation in which you use isize or usize is when indexing some sort of collection. Rust is a statically typed language, which means the compiler must know exactly the data type for each variable in your code. In most cases, the compiler can infer the type of some value, and you don't need to tell it explicitly in your code. If you're unsure of which integer type to use, Rust defaults to the i32 type, which is generally the fastest. Floating point numbers are simply numbers with decimal points. Rust floating point types are F32 and F64, which are 32 bits and 64 bits in size, respectively. The default type is F64 because on modern CPUs, it's roughly the same speed as F32, but capable of double the precision. All Rust number types support mathematical operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and remainder. The Boolean type has either a value of true or false. The Boolean type is specified using the keyword bool, and Booleans are 1 byte in size. They are most used through conditional and control flow statements, which will be covered in another video. The character type is used to represent letters. A character type is specified using the char keyword, and character literals are specified with single quotes as opposed to string literals, which use double quotes. Character types are 4 bytes in size and represent a Unicode scalar value, which can include a single letter, accented letters, emojis, and more. That's the most important detail to cover about scalar types for now. Next, I'll jump into a demo.